Martina Murring, who lives with her husband and three children in Kongwing, a tiny and sleepy village in Ribhoi district of Meghalaya, is happy that after a long wait, water has finally reached her doorsteps. The village got the individual household water connections for the first time in July this year. This has not only helped her and other women escape the drudgery of fetching water from far-off places, but also save them precious time to contribute to their other household chores.
I got the water connection in July. When I look back, I realize how difficult the life was for us women. I had to travel long distances to fetch water. Now I can devote more time to my children and other productive activities.
I appreciate enormous efforts put in by HDFC Bank and such for bringing water to all the households from the new water source. The old water source was not providing sufficient water to the village. It is really a great relief for all of us.
This tank can accommodate sufficient water to meet the requirement of the village for the 2 days. This is because the source is almost 2 kilometers away, and the pipeline is coming through a very treacherous terrain. So even if there is a breakdown, we can do the repair in 1 day, and during that period, the supply to the villagers is not affected at all.
Kongwing is not the only village in Meghalaya which was facing water scarcity, despite the state being the wettest place in the country. Almost all the villages in the state are confronting this strange paradox. Though the state's PHE department provided community water platforms in the villages, the individual household water connections still remain a distant dream. But now the situation is going through a major transformation. Thanks to the Holistic Rural Development Project, a corporate social responsibility or CSR initiative by HDFC Bank Limited being implemented by Society for Action in Community Health, or SACH, in 12 villages of Umling and 5 villages of Jurang Block of Ribhoi District. Apart from Kongwing, 3 more villages, Markang, Umpathau and Umwang Nongba, also got household water connections under the project. Also, the existing water tanks, platforms and pipelines were repaired at many places.
This would indeed bring a huge relief to the entire village. My family is waiting for the moment when the water will flow from this tap. As you can see, water pipelines are being laid here. We have 126 households in the village, and all the households will receive water connections in a few days' time.
We have selected our sources based on 3 criteria: adequacy, reliability and sustainability.
Here you can see the water filter and a water storage tank we repaired in village Marmain. This improved the availability of water for the local people.
The biggest challenge was to find the perennial water sources in these villages. They were developed and constructed to supply water throughout the year. In Umwang Nongba, 3 water sources were merged together for 2 villages, Markang and Dondral, to ensure water supply even during the winters. Approximately 32,730 meters of pipelines were laid through difficult and hilly terrains to bring water from sources to villages and households.
Locating perennial water sources in Meghalaya is quite a huge challenge. We have to spend almost 1 month with the local community finding new sources.
This system supplies water to 2 villages. This was the original structure, which was the collection point for supplying water to village Dondral. We constructed this additional structure, which is collecting water, tapping it and taking it to 2 villages, another part of Dondral and new village Markang. In rainy season, you often get debris and soil which can clog the particles. This structure, made of stone and wire netting that you see behind me, is gabion, which prevents stones and smaller pebbles entering into the collection chamber.
We would come this far to use this water for some rituals. We are thankful to Swachh, which developed this source to provide drinking water throughout the year.
Apart from drinking water supply, the major focus of the HRD project is to increase the livelihood opportunities in these villages through interventions in farm and non-farm sectors, such as sustainable agricultural practices, promotion of horticulture crops, livestock, skill training, micro-enterprise for women and youth. Improving quality of education and school infrastructure is also central to this huge initiative. On agri-horticulture front, the project seeks to increase farm productivity and cropping intensity by introducing new crops in the region, especially during the winter season. For this, Swachh facilitated orientation programs, farm demonstration, soil health cards for the farmers, and free seeds distribution with support from KVK and ICAR.
We used to grow groundnuts, but the low yield forced us to shift to other unprofitable crops. Now, after the intervention by Swachh, which provided us training and seeds, the farmers have sowed groundnuts. We hope this time the yield would be high and would give us good profit.
We tied up with KVK to facilitate them training and demonstration on groundnut. We provided them seeds and insecticides to ensure that the seeds grow well and give them good benefit.
I am happy that for the first time Swachh provided me free paddy seeds of different types. So this year I don't have to buy them from the market.
We have taken the soil samples from the different villages of Umling and Jirang blocks, and we have tested in our mini soil testing labs and distributed the soil health cards to the farmers.
The KVK River, in collaboration with Swachh, we have conducted four numbers of farmers orientation program in Umling and Jirang block of Meghalaya. The programs were conducted with an objective to show the technological interventions of ICR to the farmers, so that they can attain maximum production out of the crops they are growing.
Organic farming got a major boost to enhance soil nutrition under the initiative. For this, farmers were trained to set up vermicompost and trichoderma units in all the intervention villages. One community resource person, Bindas Sayem from Malong village, has helped the farmers set up over a dozen vermicompost units.
Today, I'm in Umlakha village to help other CRPs and farmers set up vermicompost units. I got the training in RRTC. From here, I would go to four more villages.
This is one example of how Swachh is promoting vermicompost in its intervention villages to enhance the soil nutrition. We are doing this through training and capacity building of community resource persons.
Orientation programs were held and seeds distributed for kitchen gardens to help families get access to organic vegetables.
This is a kitchen garden which we set up in Ronghlik village to generate their interest in food and vegetables cultivation.
Isse mere parivar ko, mere family ko pushtik ghar ka khana mil raha.
The initiative is creating livelihood opportunities in the intervention villages, with more and more farmers becoming part of piggery, poultry, goatry and fishery groups.
I bought one male and two female goats, which have given birth to four kids. Right now, I am calculating how much I can earn and planning for expansion. My family is poor and struggling to make both ends meet. I received financial support from Swachh to start a poultry unit. The chicks that I bought are grown up now and are ready to be sold. This will surely improve the income for the family. I got these pigs 3 months back. I got training in pig rearing. Swachh helped me select and buy the good breed. This is a very good initiative for the poor.
This is our community pond, Dondral community pond, and the search teams has provided us fish links
And just now we have released the fish into the pond and the whole community will get the benefits from this pond.
This year we have been focusing on promotion of fishery, piggery and poultry unit independently. And in the next year we are planning to integrate fishery with piggery, fishery with poultry unit, so that this can increase the can further increase the income of the family.
Lack of proper school infrastructure always has an adverse impact on the performance and behavior of students. For this, Such, under the project, repaired school buildings and provided furniture, fans, sports kits and other teaching and learning tools.
After intervention of Such and HDFC Bank, the school got new look. Furnitures were provided like fans, divider, whiteboards, and other teaching materials and sports kits.
We also get the fun. Now we don't have to bear the heat.
It feels good to use the new furniture as the old one was in bad shape.
To improve quality of education, Such tied up with leading educational institutes to equip the teachers with new teaching skills.
Most of the teachers, okay, they need training in science, in maths, and in language. Okay, so we see that in those areas, okay, they have face problem in those areas. So that's why even these NGOs also they are talking with us about these things. So that's why we from the institute, okay, we said that it's better we take care on those particular area.
For the first time, the concept of smart classes was introduced in the schools.
Smart classes use all interactive modules like videos and presentations, and these visually attractive methods of teaching become appealing to students who are already struggling with the traditional method of teaching in a classroom.
It helps us to understand the subject easily.
This is entirely a new experience for the students.
Youth are being encouraged to set up small businesses with financial support envisaged under the project. For this, Such is facilitating training in micro-enterprise in collaboration with institutes such as SIRD, RRTC and IL&FS. Approximately 50 youth are undergoing skill training in trades like driving, embroidery, food and beverages, and as electricians, etc.
This training is mainly to enhance their capacity, to build them the capacity so that they will understand what is self-employment, what is the benefit that they will get personally in their family, in their villages, and the state as a whole.
The benefit of this training is that it gives us more knowledge, especially for rural people like us, to start our own businesses.
This is just the beginning. Despite huge challenges, the transformation which is taking place in these villages is real and visible.